starting the style on freshly washed hair as I normally do for my styles, and I'm using a cotton t-shirt just to help me prevent frizzing when I'm drying my hair. And my hair has been drying for about 20 minutes now at this point, so it's pretty dry. Now to prep my hair for this style, I'm going to part my hair into three sections, and I really like parting my hair into different sections because it gives me a nice overall blueprint of what the style is going to look like. So if I want to have more hair on one side, I can easily do it just by doing this method. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side, and a lot of times if I do a half style, I do part my hair like this just because it's a lot easier for me, so I can really see if the part is nice and clean, if it's nice and even, and I'm just making sure that the part is both clean and even because the parts will be showing. So right here, I'm just cleaning up the part because I realized there was some hair in the way and that is not what I want. Now I'm just clipping this front section up and out of the way so I can work on the back section first. So as many of you who watch my channel know, I use the LOC method. So for my leave-in, I'm going to use the new Mielle Organics Pomegranate and Honey Leave-In Conditioner. And I'm using a generous amount. And I really like using a good amount just because it helps my hair stay nourished and conditioned until next wash day, which will be about a week. And for my oil, I'm going to use some vitamin E oil. And I really like this oil because it helps keep my hair nice and hydrated and moisturized. Of course, the water and leave-in conditioner really help. And then the oil just helps seal that moisture in. And for my cream, I'm going to use the Mielle Organics Pomegranate and Honey Twisting Soufflé. I'm starting to part my hair in the back first for the twist, just because I feel like this gives me better manageability over the style. So I'm parting about an inch section, a little bit more than an inch, and I just like to feel my hair and just feel the part just to see if it's nice and even, and if it's not, I'll go back and just part it again. Now I'm applying a twisting souffle, and I'm applying a good amount, not as much as the leave-in conditioner, but I just want the style to hold because I'm going to keep this in for about a week, so I really want my hair to hold. I don't want the twist to unravel, especially at the ends. Now I'm making another part going vertically for the twist, and then just because I want my twist to be nice and smooth, I'm using a small rat tail comb. You can use a wide tooth comb if you'd like. I just know when I do use a small rat tail comb gently that my styles do come out a little bit better just because the hair is nice and smooth and the cuticle is smoothed down and my styles last a lot longer and my hair doesn't get frizzy this way. Just make sure that you're being very gentle. Now to two-strand twist your hair, it's pretty simple. I'm just going to take this larger section and divide my hair into half. So I'll have two sections of hair and then I'm just going to start to twist one section around the other and then do the same thing. So it's just about going in that pattern the same time. So I'm going to show you about a few more times just so you can get the hang of it. Swirl the ends around my finger a few times just to encourage the curl so it can hold nicely. Now I'm going to part an inch section again going across for a full row of the twist, and then I'm going to show you how I twist one two-strand twist. I I did like using this twisting souffle because it really helped my twist hold. The only thing that I wasn't a big fan on was the scent. Yes, it smells good, but it's very strong and it lingered in my hair for a few days and I didn't really like that so much. So again, when you're detangling your hair for your style, make sure you start from the ends and work your way up. You can use a wide tooth comb to do this. My preference is a rat tail comb just because I feel like I get a nicer, sleeker look. And then I'm just going to do my two strand twist again. And I go all the way to the ends and then twirl the ends around my finger just to really encourage that curl. And it definitely did hold for a week, which I was very pleased. I was afraid that it was going to start to unravel after a few days, but my hair definitely held up, especially at the ends, for over a week, and I'm so excited that it did. Also, every other 2 days, I did rinse all of my hair in the shower, and none of my twists came undone, and I was very excited that it didn't. I just like to really saturate my hair in water every so often for some extra moisture and hydration, and of course, I sealed it with some oil. And if you notice that your hair maybe not as smooth as you like it working towards the end, just go and comb it again. It's totally fine. And I was watching a vlog here on YouTube. I believe it was Jackie Ina and her boyfriend Dennis, their channel, and they were in LA or something like that. But whatever it was really funny. I like to watch videos while I'm doing my hair. Fast forward to completing all the twists, and I really like how my twist turned out. And here's a close-up of how some of the twists look, especially at the end. And I'm just recurling this twist with my finger just because I didn't like how the curl was. But nonetheless, my hair definitely turned out really nice and lasted for over a week. So now to jazz up my twist, I'm going to be using these beads that I got from the beauty supply store. I like how this bead looks. It looks really unique and nice. And with these shorter beads, I just opened it up and then I clamped it on the twist. So even though my hair still damp from water, I missed it on my hair and also the twisting souffle, I really like how it turned out. Also, there was no white residue left in my hair once my hair dried completely. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. And please don't forget to like, comment, share, subscribe if you haven't already. And thank you for all of your support. Also, have you watched the video on one of my favorite styles? I did two strand twist here, and on the other side, I did two strand flat twist. And it was just really nice for me, something a little bit different, a little bit edgy, and I really liked how it came out.